Welcome to AgriLearner Current Affairs, and you can join at www.agriguru.in for further current affairs related to agriculture. And today we are going to see about agricultural current affairs of month January. First question, on December 2020, CCEA approved a modified scheme to enhance ethanol distillation capacity in the country for producing 1G ethanol that will be used in. And the options are 1. Paints and varnishes, 2. Alcoholic beverages, 3. Petrochemical products, 4. Beauty products, 5. Sugar production. And the correct answer is 3. Petrochemical products. And the reason for this answer is that on December 30, 2020, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, approved a modified scheme to enhance ethanol distillation capacity in the country for producing first generation 1G ethanol from feedstocks such as cereals like rice, wheat, barley, corn, sorghum, sugarcane, sugar beet, etc. An interest subvention of ₹4,573 crore will also be provided for production of ethanol. The government has fixed target of 10% blending of fuel-grade ethanol with petrol by 2022 and 20% blending by 2030. And the second question is, where did Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar inaugurate the virtual Agri India Hackathon 2020? And the options are 1. Chandigarh, Punjab, 2. Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh, 3. Morena, Madhya Pradesh, 4. Hangul, Andhra Pradesh, 5. New Delhi, Delhi. And the correct answer is New Delhi, Delhi. And the reason is, on December 31, 2020, Narendra Singh Tomar, Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, inaugurated the virtual Agri India Hackathon 2020 in New Delhi. This two-month event is first of its kind and also the target virtual event in Indian agricultural history. The hackathon is organized by PUSA Krishi ICAR, Indian Agriculture Research Institute IARI, ICAR and Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. The Agri India Hackathon is divided into two parts, competition and Agri India meets. And the third question is, what was the permissible trans fatty acids, that is TFA level in oil and fat set by FSSAI for 2021? Options are 1. 5%, 2. 7%, 3. 2%, 4. 4%, 5. 3%. And the correct answer is 5.3%. Reason is, the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India released guidelines to reduce the permissible level of trans fatty acids in oils and fats to 3% for 2021 and 2% by 2020. And the current permissible limit is 5%. The regulation applies to edible refined oils, vanaspati, that is nothing but a partial hydrogenated oil, margarine, bakery shortenings, and other mediums of cookings like vegetable fat spreads and mixed fat spreads. The TFA is associated with increased risk of heart attacks and death from coronary heart diseases. Fourth question is, in which state 5 dry food parks to be established as per the MOU signed between TRIFED and Akhil Bharatiya Vanvasi Kalyan Ashram on January 2021? Options are 1. Maharashtra, 2. Telangana, 3. Punjab, 4. MP Madhya Pradesh, 5. Jharkhand. And the correct answer is 4. Madhya Pradesh. On January 3, 2021, TRIFED, that is a Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India Limited, under Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Akhil Bharatiya Vanvasi Kalyan Ashram, signed a MOU to establish TRIFED parks in 5 districts in Madhya Pradesh. The main aim of TRIFED is to enhance the income of tribals through optimum utilization of value addition to minor forest products. And the fifth question is, which is the first northeastern Indian state to have a specialized ginger processing plant? And the options are Tripura, Assam, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Sikkim. And the correct answer is option 4, Meghalaya. Northeast first ever specialized ginger processing plant at district Ri Bohe in Meghalaya is being revived and is likely to become functional in the beginning of 2021. This is not a new one. It was already established in the year 2004 and it was remained non-functional for many years. And the sixth question is, where did Adani Green Energy Limited, AGEL, recently commissioned a 100 megawatt MW solar power project in January 2021? And the options are 1. Madhya Pradesh, 2. Assam, 3. West Bengal, 4. Kolkata and 5. Gujarat. And the correct answer is 5. Gujarat. Adani Green Energy Limited has commissioned a 100 megawatt solar power project at Kisara in Gujarat. It was made a 25-year power purchase agreement with a Gujarat Urja Vikas Nigam India with PPA priced at rupees 2.44 per kilowatt hour. Seventh question is, which animal found in some parts of Rajasthan and Gujarat was recently added to India's critically endangered species list in January 2021? And options is ocelot, Ganges shark, fennec fox, Kashmiri red stag, caracal. Caracal is the animal which was considered as critically endangered species list in India, which belongs to the cat family. On January 7, 2021, the Standing Committee of National Board of Wildlife in its 60th meeting approved the advisory for management of human-wildlife conflict in the country. To expedite effective interdepartmental coordinated actions, Caracal, a medium-sized wild cat found in some parts of Rajasthan and Gujarat, included in the list of critically endangered species. Currently, there are 22 wildlife species under the government's recovery program as a critically endangered species. Question 8. Where is the Cherry Blossom Moa Festival celebrated annually? And the options are 1. Uttarakhand, 2. Jaipur, 3. Manipur, 4. Sikkim, 5. is Arunachal Pradesh. And the correct answer is 3. Manipur. Manipur celebrates a Cherry Blossom Moa Festival to promote tourism. On January 9, 2021, an annual Cherry Blossom Moa Festival was held at Moa in Senapati district, Manipur. It was virtually inaugurated by Chief Minister of Manipur and Biren Singh from the CM Secretariat in Imphal amid COVID-19. The festival marked the beginning of pink season in the district. The Moa area of Senapati district in Manipur is known for cherry blossom, a plant which is popularly known as sakura in Japan. Now, question 9. Which organization partnered with Niti Aayog to launch the updated version of Women Entrepreneurship Platform WEP in January 2021? And the options are 1. Google, 2. Flipkart, 3. Bharati Airtel, 4. Byju's, 5. Amazon. And the correct answer is 2. Flipkart. As per the efforts to enhance the community experience for women entrepreneurs in India, Flipkart and Niti Aayog have collaborated to launch the updated Women Entrepreneurship Platform. WEP is a first-of-its-kind unified access portal launched by Niti Aayog in 2017 to support women entrepreneurs. The revamped platform has multiple regional language support, along with free credit ratings, mentorship, funding support to women entrepreneurs, apprenticeship and corporate partnerships. Question 10. The scheme replaced two existing crop insurance schemes, National Agricultural Insurance Scheme and Modified National Agricultural Insurance Scheme on 13th January 2016. And the options are Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Kisan Mandan Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, Paramparak Krishi Vikas Yojana. And the correct answer is Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Government of India Crop Insurance Scheme, that is PMFBY, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, has completed 5 years of its operation. It was launched by government on 13th January 2016. The scheme is in line with One Nation, One Scheme theme. It replaces two existing crop insurance schemes as mentioned below. It is NAIS and MNAIS, that is a modified NAIS. The scheme was made voluntary for all farmers post-revamp in February 2020. Under the scheme, the premium rates are 2% for carif crops, 1.5% for rabi crops, and for commercial and horticulture crops, it is 5%. Question 11. Where did Geological Survey of India, GSI, found promising concentrations of vanadium in January 2021? And the options are 1. Assam, 2. Arunachal Pradesh, 3. Gujarat, 4. Bihar, and 5. Manipur. Correct answer is 2. Arunachal Pradesh. The Geological Survey of India found promising concentration of vanadium in paleoproterozoic carbonaceous phyllite rocks in the Dipo and Tamang areas of Papam Per district in Arunachal Pradesh. The largest deposits of vanadium of the world are in China, followed by Russia and then in South Africa. Question 12. What does SE stand for in CSIR, NISC, PR, an institute formed by merging two existing countries, CSIR, NISCAIR and CSIR, NISTADS? And the options are one, science, science computing, science communication, societal component, societal commerce. And the correct answer is science communication. On January 14, 2021, Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister of Science and Technology, Earth Sciences and Health and Family Welfare, inaugurated a new institute of Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR, that is CSIR, National Institute of Science Communication and Policy Research, in New Delhi. This institute, as established by merging two prestigious institutes of CSIR, NISCAIR and CSIR, NISTADS. 13th question, which state recently got its first Doppler weather radars that has inaugurated by Union Minister Harshvardhan on the 146th Foundation Day of Indian Meteorological Department, IMD, in January 2021? And the options are 1. Uttarakhand, 2. Assam, 3. Himachal Pradesh, 4. Sikkim, 5. Arunachal Pradesh. And the correct answer is 1. Uttarakhand. The 146th Foundation Day of IMD was held on January 15, 1921 in New Delhi. Dr. Harshvardhan inaugurated Doppler weather radars at Mukteshwar, Uttarakhand and Kufri, Himachal Pradesh. Doppler weather radars in Uttarakhand is first of its kind. The radar has been installed under the Integrated Himalayan Meteorological Project of the Ministry of Earth Sciences. He also released a special issue of Mausam on Tropical Cyclone. 14th question, PM Modi recently announced a seed fund worth rupees 1000 crore for Dash as of January 2021. First, startups. Second is CSR fund. 3 is Green Revolution 2.0. 4th is Fisheries Sector. And 5th is White Revolution 2.0. And the correct answer is 1. Startups. On January 15, 16, 2021, a 2-day event, Parambaram, Startup India International Summit 2021. Prime Minister Narendra Modi interacted with startups and addressed the summit on January 16, 2021. In an important move, he announced a seed fund worth rupees 1000 crore for startups to set up and to enhance their business. India is one of the biggest nations in the startup ecosystem with more than 41,000 startups, with nearly 5,700 in the IT sector, 3,600 in the health sector and 1,700 startups in agriculture sector. Question 15. Which state recently organized its first state-level bird festival, Kalrav, in January 2021? And the options are 1. Assam, 2. Nagaland, 3. Bihar, 4. Telangana, 5. Punjab. And the correct option is answer 3. Bihar. Bihar's first state-level bird festival, Kalrav, was held on January 17, 2021 in Nagi Nakti Bird Sanctuary, Jammu District, Bihar. It was formally inaugurated by Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar on January 16, 2021. Bihar's Environment, Forest and Climate Change Department organized an event at Nagi Nakti Bird Sanctuary on the inauguration day. The festival aims to create awareness about birds, especially migratory birds. Question 16. What was the target year set under the modified 1G ethanol scheme to achieve 20% blending of ethanol with fossil fuels in January 2021? And the options are 1. 2022, 2. 2030, 3. 2024, 4. 2028 and 5. 2025. And the correct option is 5. 2025. And the reason for this is Department of Food and Public Distribution has notified a modified scheme to extend financial assistance for producer of first generation, that is 1G ethanol, from feedstock such as cereal, sugarcane and sugar beet. The financial assistance will also be extended to project proponents for increasing their ethanol distillation capacity. The main objective behind this scheme is to achieve 20% blending of ethanol with fossil fuels by 2025, which was previously targeted at 2030. It will help in reducing pollution, help in lowering India's energy import dependency, will lower the crude oil import bill. Question 17. Which state announced the allotment of 7219 Fair Price Shops FPS across the state under its Ghar Ghar Rozgar Ti Karobar mission? Options are 1. Madhya Pradesh, 2. Karnataka, 3. Rajasthan, 4. Jharkhand and 5. Punjab. And the correct answer is 5. Punjab. Punjab is the state which announced the allotment of 7219 fair price shops across the state under its Ghar Ghar Rozgar Ki Karobar mission.
Reason for this is Punjab Chief Minister Amarinder Singh started the allotment of 7,219 fair price shops across the state. The allotment of FPS will help in improving the economic condition of people and will strengthen the PDS, that is a public distribution system. Around 30,000 people are expected to benefit because of this scheme. Since the inception of this scheme in 2017, the state government has facilitated more than 15 lakh placements of self-employment. Question 18. Recently in January 2021, WE Hub and iHub signed an memorandum of understanding for supporting startups by women. WE Hub and iHub are initiatives of dash and dash state governments. Option 1, Telangana, Kerala. 2, Delhi, Telangana. 3, Kerala, Gujarat. 4, Telangana, Gujarat. 5, Punjab and Kerala. And the correct option is 4, Telangana and Gujarat. Reason is WE Hub of Telangana government and iHub of Gujarat government have virtually signed a MOU to enable and support startups by women to raise capital in various focus sectors. This is the first time that two state governments have partnered to support women entrepreneurs. The partnership will benefit women entrepreneurs all over India. The WE Hub in India's first state-led incubator exclusively for women entrepreneurs. It was established in 2017. By which state became the first in India to provide subsidy for electricity through direct benefit transfer? And the options are 1, Gujarat, 2, Maharashtra, 3, Punjab, 4, Andhra Pradesh, 5, Madhya Pradesh. And the correct answer is 5, Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh has become the first state to give electricity subsidy through direct benefit transfer, hereby successfully implementing one out of the three stipulated reforms in the power sector. This achievement has made it eligible for additional borrowing equivalent to 0.15% of its gross state domestic product. Phase 1 of DBT of electricity subsidy scheme to farmers was initiated by the state in its Vidisha district. In May 2020, the central government enhanced the borrowing limit of the states by 2% of their GSDP, that is gross state domestic product, in order to meet the challenges posed by the COVID-19 pandemic. Question 20. Which state introduced India's first solar electric roll-on, roll-off, that is RORO service? Options are 1, Kerala, 2, Punjab, 3, Karnataka, 4, Gujarat, 5, West Bengal. And the correct option is 1, Kerala. The country's maiden solar electric roll-on, roll-off service and Kerala's first amphibious water bus will be introduced during the year 2021 to 2022. Utilizing the potential of the national waterway corridors in the state, the Department of Water Transport will gear up to introduce badge service for cargo movement. Question 21. Which was the first state to launch door delivery of rations under the public distribution system PDS? Option 1, Goa, 2, Maharashtra, 3, Andhra Pradesh, 4, Telangana, 5, Tamil Nadu. And the correct option is 3, Andhra Pradesh. On 21st January 2021, Andhra Pradesh became the first state to launch door delivery of rations under the PDS. The scheme will benefit 26,39,363 cardholders throughout the state. The scheme will cost an additional Rs. 830 crore per annum. Question 22. What was the average daily intake of salt as per the findings of First National Non-Communicable Disease Monitoring Survey, NNMS? Options are 1, 10 gram, 2, 12 gram, 3, 15 gram, 4, 8 gram, 5, 5 gram. And the correct answer is option 4, 8 gram. On 25th January 2021, Dr. Harsh Vardhan, Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, virtually attended the Foundation Day celebrations and launch of decadal year of ICMR-NCDIR, Bengaluru, Karnataka. National Non-Communicable Disease Monitoring Survey 2017-18, first of its kind, complete survey on NCDs using standardized tools and methods. Average daily intake of salt was 8 grams, which is higher than the World Health Organization recommended level of 5 grams per day. High salt consumption leads to raised blood pressure and increases the risk of heart diseases. Question 23. Recently, in Jan 2021, Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs increased the MSP of dash in line with 1.5 times the average cost of production. And the options are groundnut in shell, 2 copra, 3 safflower, 4 masoor, 5 soya bean. And the correct answer is 2 copra. Based on the recommendations of the CACP, Commission of Agriculture Cost and Prices, Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has given its approval for the minimum support price of copra for 2021 season. In this regard, MSP for fair average quality of milling copra is increased by Rs. 375 to Rs. 10,335 per quintal, and the MSC for boiled copra has been increased by Rs. 300 to Rs. 10,600 per quintal. The increase on line with the principle of fixing the MSP at the level of at least 1.5 times the all India weighted average cost of production. Question 24. Which city will be benefited through the nutrition program launched by UN World Food Program, that is United Nations World Food Program, in collaboration with Cargill as of January 2021? And the options are 1. Mumbai, Maharashtra. 2. Jaipur, Rajasthan. 3. Dispur, Assam. 4. Ahmedabad, Gujarat. 5. New Delhi. And the correct answer is 2. Jaipur, Rajasthan. On January 27, 2021, Cargill, in collaboration with UNWFP and Center for Responsible Business CRB, launched a program to improve nutrition status in Jaipur, Rajasthan. This program is supported by Department of Women and Child Development, Government of Rajasthan. The program aims to address the nutritional intake in first 1,000 days of child life, that is from conception to 2 years birth after birth. Question 25. Which was not one among the measures mentioned in the marine mega fauna stranding guidelines released by MOEFCC in January 2021? Options are 1. Boost scientific research. 2. Rebuilding of degraded habitats of marine mammals. 3. Reduced stranding of marine turtles. 4. Increasing fish population. 5. Increasing people's participation in conservation. And the correct answer is 4. Increasing fish population. On January 29, 2021, Prakash Javadekar, Union Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, virtually released Marine Megafauna Stranding Guidelines and National Marine Turtle Action Plan in New Delhi. Some of the guidelines are: improve the response of stakeholders towards stranding, entanglement, injury of marine mammals and conservation of marine turtles; boost scientific research and exchange of information; rebuilding of degraded habitats of marine mammals; increasing people's participation in conservation. Question 26. Which state government recently, in Jan 2021, launched the Agriculture Pump Power Connection Policy 2020? And the options are 1. Gujarat. 2. Karnataka. 3. Maharashtra. 4. Andhra Pradesh. 5. West Bengal. And the correct answer is 3. Maharashtra. On January 28, 2021, Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray launched the Agriculture Pump Power Connection Policy 2020, which aims to provide uninterrupted power supply to the farmers. He also inaugurated several farm-related initiatives like solar energy, land bank portal, Krishi Urja Abhiyan Policy 2020 web portal, ACF app developed by Power Discom, Mahavitran and Mahakrishi Abhiyan app. Question 27. Which country will replace South Korea to co-chair the International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, supported Asia Protected Areas Partnership, APAP, for 3 years? And the options are 1. Bangladesh. 2. China. 3. Japan. 4. India. 5. Indonesia. And the correct answer is 4. India. India is all set to co-chair the International Union for Conservation of Nature supported Asia Protected Areas Partnership, a regional forum to conserve wildlife habitats, for 3 years. In this tenure, India will assist other Asian countries in managing their protected areas. India will replace South Korea, which held this position for 3 years till November 2020. Notably, APAP is chaired by IUCN Asia and co-chaired by an APAP country member. Question 28. Which bank collaborated with Asian Development Bank, ADB, to make oceans clean and sustainable to achieve Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs, and climate goals under Paris Agreement as of January 2021? And the options are 1. Reserve Bank of India. 2. World Bank. 3. European Investment Bank. 4. Bank for International Settlements. And 5. New Development Bank. And the correct answer is 3. European Investment Bank. On January 15, 2021, the Asian Development Bank, ADB, and the European Investment Bank initiated a clean and sustainable ocean partnership to achieve sustainable development goals. and the climate goals as advised in the Paris Agreement. In this regard, both entities will support the initiatives in Asia and the Pacific. They will also develop joint technical assistance programs and advisory support to help their partners in achieving SDGs of blue economy. Healthy oceans are a key priority of ADB Strategy 2030. Question 29. Which country or countries virtually participated with India in January 2021 for the first time to discuss IPR issues, that is intellectual property rights issues? Options are 1. USA, 2. European Union, 3. Japan, 4. Indonesia, 5. Both 3 and 4. And the correct answer is 2. European Union. On January 19, 2021, the first India-EU IPR dialogue 2021 was held virtually between European Union Commission and Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade to discuss key intellectual property right issues affecting businesses. Indian side gave a general review on the IPR developments inclined with National IPR Policy 2016, which resulted in legislative reforms to stimulate innovation and creativity among startups and MSMEs. Thank you. And you can join www.agriguru.in for further details about agriculture current affairs.